Welcome to video on high voltage engineering for 7th semester electrical engineering. We are going to consider unit 5, measurement of high voltage and current, and this is the 7th video in this series. We are going to consider measurement of peak value of AC voltages using digital peak voltmeter and peak voltmeter with potential divider arrangement. Prior to this video, we have studied a method based on series capacitance based peak voltmeter, which had a drawback of being able to measure only purely sinusoidal voltages and multiple peaks if they are present within the AC voltage waveform, then those multiple peaks were responsible for introducing errors. So digital peak voltmeters are proposed. Learning objectives for this topic are to understand the principle and working of digital peak voltmeter, and later on study the circuit operation of peak voltmeter using potential divider arrangement, and lastly discuss the various sources of error in potential divider arrangement. So this is the second method for measurement of peak voltages for AC. Kindly focus your attention on this diagram. This is the digital peak voltmeter arrangement. It consists of a capacitor connected to the high voltage supply, right, along with a resistance for carrying the discharge current during the negative half cycle through the capacitor. So the rectified current will be flowing through resistance R, and voltage developed across this resistance during the half cycle will be converted using a voltage to frequency converter. So there will be a medium frequency obtained with respect to this rectified current obtained through the diode D2. So this frequency is compared with the supply frequency using a gate circuit, which is controlled from the power supply frequency as indicated by using an assembly here on the left hand side of the diagram. It works based on the supply frequency and compares this frequency to calculate a ratio of medium frequency to the supply frequency. The medium frequency is the one obtained from voltage to frequency converter. Then gate circuit will enable the counter for a duration decided by the supply frequency, and counter will count the number of pulses. So this number of pulses that are counted by this counter, they are found to be proportional to the peak value of voltage applied across the capacitor. So this is how the digital peak voltmeter works. Now let us go into the circuit operation details of digital peak voltmeter. The problem of multiple peaks in voltage waveform produced error with the use of series capacitor peak voltmeter method. So to overcome those problem, digital peak voltmeters are used. Digital peak voltmeters do not rely on the purely the rectified charging current, but rather an analog voltage is derived from the rectified charging current and it is converted into a medium frequency represented by FM. The ratio of frequency obtained from such a analog voltage with respect to the supply frequency is measured by the gate circuit, which is controlled from the AC power frequency source, and a counter is enabled for an adjustable period delta T equal to small p by f, where small p represents the constant of the counter circuit. It will be remaining open for a specified period as decided by the constant of the counter circuit. During this period delta T, right, a number of pulses are counted. They are represented as equal to small n, and with a bit of analysis it can be observed that the number of pulses, they are actually dependent upon the peak value of voltage Vm. Apart from the other factors like 2pc is the value of capacitance, capital A and R. So the value of capacitance, value of resistance, value of small p, that is a constant for the instrument, and capital A, these are known. So number of pulses will directly represent the peak value of unknown voltage to be measured. Here A represents the voltage to frequency conversion factor as Fm upon R into Im, where Im is the current, the rectified half wave current flowing through resistance R. So this is the equation, n is equal to Fm delta T, that is equal to twice Pc Vm A into R. Other factors remaining constant, n is directly proportional to Vm, the count, number of pulses. Let us come to the second method in this particular discussion for measurement of peak AC voltages using peak voltmeter with a potential divider arrangement. If you remember, potential dividers have been used for measuring the DC and AC voltages. So resistance potential dividers are used, capacitance potential dividers are used for AC. A similar arrangement can be used with respect to measurement of peak AC voltages. Kindly focus the attention that the potential divider elements are capacitor C1. This is a large capacitance. Maximum voltage will be appearing across this capacitor. This may be compressed air or gas insulated type of capacitor. Capacitor C2, this is a relatively low voltage capacitor and having mica or paper as dielectric. Further, there is a storage capacitor used for measuring the peak value of AC voltage. A storage capacitor is being used along with diode D. So what will happen is that as capacitor, as alternating current AC voltage is applied across series combination of capacitor C1 and C2, so voltage across capacitor C2 will rise sinusoidally, and when it reaches a peak value, the charge will be delivered to capacitor Cs. So capacitor Cs will get charged to voltage equal to that of capacitor, voltage across capacitor C2. And as the voltage falls away from the peak amplitude, diode D will be reverse biased. So charge on capacitor Cs will be hold on to Cs only, right, and it will be measured by a high impedance electrostatic voltmeter. So the description that we are using here is the simple operation how capacitance potential divider can be used for charging storage capacitor Cs to the peak value of voltage across C2, which can be related to the unknown voltage being measured directly through the transformation ratio of the divider. Now there are various other elements present on the circuit. The first and foremost element we are going to see its relevance. So this is how you can observe that capacitor CS, storage capacitor, will get charged to the peak value as visible in the form of the flow of current and indication for the voltage, right. What is observed is that as this capacitor, storage capacitor CS, is of large value and it has to discharge through a voltmeter of very high impedance, so the charge on storage capacitor cannot move towards C2 because diode D gets reverse biased. And unless and until the AC voltage again rises to a peak value, by that time the charge on capacitor CS will remain nearly constant and will be measured by the electrostatic voltmeter. As the time progresses, it is observed that the voltage across capacitor CS no more follows the charging and discharging cycle of capacitor potential divider, capacitor C2. So in order to synchronize the discharge timing of capacitor CS with respect to C2, a discharge resistance RD is connected in the circuit across the storage capacitor CS on the right hand side of diode D. So with the presence of discharge resistance, the negative discharge current for capacitor CS and C2 will be matched with the power supply frequency. The time constant RDCS is chosen such that it is less than or equal to 1 second. It is realized that due to the presence of discharge resistance, what happens is that both capacitor C2 as well as CS, they undergo a discharge continuously even if the input voltage remains constant. Hence, in order to minimize this kind of discharge of capacitor C2 through the discharge resistance, a biasing resistance is introduced across capacitor C2 as visible here by the green color resistance branch. Okay. With the presence of this biasing resistance, the error due to presence of discharge resistance, this discharge resistance causes capacitor C2 as well as capacitor CS to discharge even during the charging cycle. So this can be taken care by a biasing resistor, or it can be managed by connecting an equalizing circuit as visible on the left hand side. It consists of capacitor CS, the discharge resistance RD, along with an additional diode. So this is how the peak voltmeter with a potential divider arrangement works. Let us go into the operational details of the circuit. The first and foremost point is that peak reading capacitance voltmeter circuit can be understood by considering it to subdivided it into two main sections, namely measuring circuit on the right hand side of a diagram and the equalizing circuit on the left hand side. The capacitance CS in the measuring circuit will get charged to the peak value of voltage across C2, and then this voltage can be measured by high impedance voltmeter or electrostatic voltmeter shown in the diagram. Due to the high impedance of voltmeter, the charge on capacitor CS will be held for a long duration, more than 1 second. And as the supply voltage reduces away from peak, the diode D will be reverse biased, that we have already seen during the description from the circuit diagram. But due to the isolation of capacitor CS, it will no longer follow the supply voltage across capacitor C2. So what we want is that the charging and discharging of storage capacitor matches with the timing of charging and discharging of capacitor C2. Okay. Hence, an additional discharge resistance RD is connected to overcome this problem such that time constant RDCS is approximately equal to 1 second. Further, due to the presence of discharge resistance, although this is meant for synchronizing the charging and discharging time of capacitors C2 and CS, it is observed that a discharge error is introduced as capacitors CS and C2 keep discharging always even when the input voltage remains constant. So this is called as a discharge error resulting due to the presence of resistance RD. The second source of error is due to the ripple content of voltage across storage capacitor CS. So this ripple content, although small, it depends upon the supply frequency. And third source of error is the error in the recharging of storage capacitor when diode is forward biased. The storage capacitor must be charged to the peak value, but due to discharge resistance, some voltage drop occurs during the charging. So this problem, as I mentioned earlier also, can be addressed by using a biasing resistance across capacitor C2 on the left hand side of diode D and also keeping value of storage capacitor slightly less than the capacitance C2. All these errors that are mentioned above have been minimized or could be minimized by a modification in the circuit. So the modification is in the form of an equalizing circuit as shown on the left hand side of the measuring branch. So it takes care of the net error that is caused due to charging and discharging cycle of storage capacitor. So let us now summarize what we have learned in this particular video. We have studied actually two methods. One is the digital peak voltmeter method. So digital peak voltmeter method, it works on the principle of converting rectified AC charging current into a proportional frequency and then enabling a counter using a gate circuit, and this gate circuit it is synchronized with the power supply frequency. So it enables the counter in proportion to the half cycle period of the supply frequency. The digital measurements, although they are accurate, but digital circuits, these are costlier and they require checking the electromagnetic compatibility in the presence of strong electric fields nearby the high voltage circuits. And lastly, the capacitance potential divider based peak reading voltmeter method uses storage capacitor to measure the peak AC voltage, but the error due to charging and discharging cycle needs additional modification in the form of equalizing circuit for measurements. So this way we have studied two methods in this particular video for measurement of peak AC voltages. If you have any queries, then kindly share them during the online session. Thanks for watching.